Now, the freight cars are silly and noisy. They talk a lot and don't attend to what they are doing. And I'm sorry to say, they play tricks on an engine who is not used to them. Edward knew all about the freight cars. He warned Thomas to be careful, but Thomas was too excited to listen. The shunter fastened the coupling, and when the signal dropped, Thomas was ready. The conductor blew his whistle, beep, beep, answered Thomas, and started off. But the freight cars weren't ready. Oh, oh, they screamed. Wait, Thomas, wait. But Thomas wouldn't wait. Come on, come on, he puffed. All right, don't fuss. All right, don't fuss, grumbled the cars. Thomas began going faster and faster. Whoosh, he whistled as he rushed through Henry's tunnel. Hurry, hurry, called Thomas. He was feeling very proud of himself. But the cars grew crosser and crosser. At last, Thomas slowed down as he came to Gordon's Hill. Steady now, steady, warned the driver as they reached the top. He began to put on the brakes. We're stopping, called Thomas. No, 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 answered the cars, bumping into each other. Go on, go on. Before the driver could stop them, they had pushed Thomas down the hill and were rattling and laughing behind him. Poor Thomas tried hard to stop them from making him go too fast. Stop them. Station. Oh dear, what shall I do? Cried Thomas. They rattled straight through and swerved into the goods yard. Thomas shut his eyes. I must stop. When he opened his eyes, he saw he had stopped just in front of the buffers.